If a bar equal to I plus j plus k, b bar is 2i minus j plus 3k, and c bar is I minus 2j plus k, then find box A bar, B bar, C bar. If A bar is I plus J plus K, B bar is 2I minus J plus 3K, C bar is the vector I minus 2J plus K, then find box A bar, B bar, C bar. Box A bar, B bar, C bar. Box A bar, B bar, C bar is the determinant of the components of ijk components of A bar. Those are 1, 1, 1. Similarly, ijk components of B bar, the second vector, minus 1, 2, minus 1, 3. Ijk components of C bar, 1, minus 2, 1. This determinant gives us the box value, that means scalar triple product value. That means A bar dot B cross C, otherwise A cross B dot C bar, one and the same. So that is 1 into minus 1 into 1, minus 1 plus 6. Similarly, minus 1 into 2 minus 3, plus 1 into minus 4 plus 1. So the required, here the value is 5, here the plus 1, there minus 3. So 6 minus 3, 3. Once box A, B, C, box A bar, B bar, C bar is non-zero, certainly the vectors are coplanar. Now once the box A, B, C is non-zero, then the vectors are non-coplanar. Here, box A bar, B bar, C bar is not equal to 0. Hence, we can say vectors A bar, B bar, C bar are non-coplanar. If the box value is 0, then we can say they are coplanar. Next one. If A bar is I plus 4J plus 2K, B bar is 3I minus 2J plus 7K, C bar is 2I minus J plus 4K, represents vectors along the coterminal edges. Coterminal edges of a tetrahedron then its volume is, if A bar, B bar, C bar represents coterminal edges of a tetrahedron, then its volume is volume of the tetrahedra, volume of tetrahedra is 1/6 of modulus of box A bar B bar C bar. 1/6 of modulus of box A bar B bar C bar. Box A bar B bar C bar is a scalar. Scalar triple product of the vectors. Once finding box A bar B bar C bar, we get a scalar. That scalar by 6 gives us volume of the tetrahedron. Volume never be negative, hence I am taking modulus. So that is, therefore, box A bar B bar C bar is, since they are coterminal edges of tetrahedron, straight away box A bar B bar C bar is 1, 4, 2, 3, minus 2, 7, 2, minus 1, 4. This is 1 into minus 8 plus 7, minus 4 into 12 minus 14 plus 2 into minus 3 plus 4. It gives us minus 1 here and plus 8 and plus 2, which is 9. Therefore, volume is volume equal to 1/6 of 9. 9 is positive, hence no need of taking modulus. So this is 3/2, 1.5 cubic units. Since that is cubic units, 1.5, that is 1.5 cubic units is the volume of the tetrahedron, whose coterminal edges are A bar, B bar, C bar. Coterminal edges in the sense, you can take, suppose A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D is a tetrahedron. A, B bar, A, C bar, A, D bar. Coterminal edges. Let us suppose this is A bar, this is B bar, this is C bar. Once AB bar is A bar, AC bar is B bar, AD bar is C bar. Then volume of the tetrahedron B is 1/6 of modulus of AB bar, AC bar, AD bar. That is the volume of the tetrahedron. If A is 1, 1, 1, B is 2, 5, 0, C is 3, 2, minus 3, and D is 1, minus 6, minus 1. B vertices of a tetrahedron then its volume. Yes. If A, B, C, D are the vertices of a tetrahedron, then its volume is. Instead of coterminal edges, once the vertices are given to us, once the vertices are given, this is A, this is B, this is C, D. Let us suppose this is 1, 1, 1. This is 2, 5, 0. Of course, this is 3, 2, minus 3. this is 1 minus 6 minus 1. Suppose these are the vertices of a tetrahedron, then volume of the tetrahedron is. To get the volume of the tetrahedron, find coterminal edges here. Consider here OA bar is I plus J plus K. OB bar 2I plus 5J plus 0K. OC bar, the position vector of C, 3I plus 2J minus 3K. The position vector of vertex D, I minus 6J minus K. Once OA bar, OB bar, OC bar and OD bar be position vectors of vertices A, B, C, D, then AB bar, the vector AB bar is OB bar minus OA bar. This is I plus 4J, 0 minus 1, so minus K. AC bar, OC minus OA. OC minus OA is 2I plus J minus 4K. AD bar, OD minus OA. OD minus OA, 0I minus 6 minus 1, minus 7J, minus 1 minus, minus 2K. Find AB bar, AC bar, AD bar. These three are coterminal edges of tetrahedron. So therefore, volume of tetrahedron, volume of tetrahedron ABCD is 1/6 of modulus of box AB bar, AC bar, AD bar itself. Modulus of the determinant. Modulus of the determinant of AB obtained by AB bar, AC bar, AD bar components. That is 1, 4, minus 1. Components of AC bar, 2, 1, minus 4. Components of AD bar, 0, minus 7, minus 2. I am taking modulus to the determinant. Find the determinant value and take the modulus. 1/6 of modulus of 1 into minus 2 minus 28 minus 4 into minus 4 0 plus minus 1 into minus 14 0. That is 1/6 of minus 30 plus 16. This is plus 14. Clearly this is 0. 0 by 6, that is. Volume equal to 0 means all the four points be in a plane. Once all the four points ABCD are in the same plane, the volume is 0. Hence the tetrahedron does not form here. That we can conclude in such a way. So that is, therefore, the points, since volume is 0, the points ABCD lies in a plane or coplanar here. Hence volume of the tetrahedron formed by these four points is 0. In the tetrahedron, three points are coplanar and one does not lies in the plane of BCD, in the plane of its opposite face. What is its sort of A? If you consider the vertex A, its opposite face is BCD. The triangle BCD. Triangle is in one face, one plane, and the fourth vertex is in another plane. Hence, ABCD are non-coplanar in such case. once ABCD are non-coplanar only, the tetrahedron forms. Otherwise, it does not form the tetrahedron. In such case, once you find the volume of the tetrahedron, it becomes zero. Once volume is zero, you can say that the points ABCD are coplanar. Okay. Now vector triple product, already scalar triple product is obtained by box of that vectors. Already we discussed in previous class how to evaluate the scalar triple product of the vectors. Similarly, vector triple product, the resultant of the product of three vectors is a vector. If A bar, B bar, C bar are given vectors, then vector triple product of these vectors, triple product of these vectors is defined as A bar cross B bar cross C bar, or A bar cross B bar cross C bar, or C bar cross A bar cross B bar, like this, etc. Cross product of two vectors, and then cross product of the resultant of two vectors with the third vector gives us the vector triple product. Of course, these two need not be equal. These two need not be equal. Now, next point. If A bar If A bar, B bar, C bar are non-zero vectors, then A bar cross B bar cross C bar, the vector triple product may be evaluated with the dot product as A dot C multiplied B bar minus A dot B multiplied C bar. That means the vector triple product, the vector triple product can be evaluated with the help of dot product. A dot C, A dot, leaving the middle one, take the dot product of these two, multiplied B bar, this is a scalar into B bar, minus product of these two successive vectors, that means dot product of A and B multiplied C bar. That means this vector may be expressed as some X into B bar, some Y into C bar, as a linear combination of B and C. It can be expressed as a linear combination of B and C. You can prove this one. Let us take the proof. To prove this, let us consider A bar is just AI. Okay. B bar is B1i plus B2j. For our calculation purpose, simple calculation purpose, just I am taking that vectors like that. C1i plus C2j plus C3k. This is in space. This is in xy plane. This is along x-axis. Just I am taking the vectors in such a way for simple calculation. Otherwise, you can take ai plus bj plus ck like that also. But the calculation, you cannot, to minimize the calculation, you can take a bar, b bar, c bar. Without loss of generality, you can take like that. Now, consider the cross product of b and c initially. Now, b cross c. To find LHS, find b cross c. B cross c is I, j, k. B1, B2, 0. C1, C2, C3. Evaluating this vector B cross C, we get B2, C3, I. Next, minus J into B1, C3, J. K term. B1, C2 minus B2, C1, K. This is B cross C. Again LHS part, A bar cross, B bar cross, C bar, that is again I, J, K. The second row is components of A bar. Components of A bar is clearly A, 0, 0. Otherwise, you take A1 here, for convenience sake A1. And B cross C, B cross C components of B2 C3 minus B1 C3, B1 C2 minus B2 C1. Treating this one as vector, evaluate the determinant. Otherwise, evaluate the cross product, treating this one as one vector. Okay. Now, this is 0 minus 0, there is no I term. Next. Minus A1 into B1 C2 minus B2 C1 into 0 K into minus A1 B1 C3 K. This is our LHS here. Similarly, find the RHS dot product. Here RHS. A bar dot C bar multiplied B bar equal to this term. A bar dot C bar multiplied B bar. A bar dot B bar. A bar dot, sorry, A bar dot C bar. A bar dot C bar is dot product of these two vectors. That is A1 C1. The remaining terms becomes 0, 0 into C2 plus 0 into C3. And A bar dot B bar into C bar. A bar dot B bar, that is A1 B1. Oh, this is B bar. B bar is B1i plus B2j here. And A dot B is A1 B1 multiplied C bar. Multiplied C bar is C1i plus C2j plus C3k. Okay. Subtraction of these two. Therefore, RHS. RHS is A bar dot C bar multiplied B bar minus A bar dot B bar multiplied C bar. This is A1 C1 B1 into I plus A1 B2 C1 into J, this vector minus this vector A1 B1 C1 I plus A1 B1 C2 J plus A1, B1, C3, K. Now subtraction of these vectors gives us the RHS value. A1 C1 B1 into I. A1 B1 C1 into I. So these two vectors cancel. Coming to J terms, A1 B2 C1, A1 B1 C2. So A1 B2 C1 minus A1 B1 C2 into J minus A1 B1 C3 K. Okay. Clearly this is on simplification. On simplification we get A1 B2 C1 minus A1 B1 C2 J minus A1 B1 C3 K. Which is clearly, this one is clearly LHS. This LHS. This is LHS. Therefore, LHS equal to, here LHS equal to A1 B2 C1 minus A1 B1 C2 J minus of A1 B1 C3 K. Okay. That LHS is same to that of RHS. So that the vector triple product A bar cross B bar cross C bar is from right to left, from left to right, A dot C multiplied B minus A dot B multiplied C. So, evaluation of vector triple product by dot product. Similarly, A bar cross B bar cross C bar may be written as dot product of these two, A dot C multiplied B bar minus B dot C multiplied A bar. A linear combination of B and A, whereas this is the linear combination of B and C. So hence these two are not equal. These two are not equal. You can express this one as a combination of B and A. Scalar multiple of B plus scalar multiple of A. But whereas here this vector is scalar multiple of B plus scalar multiple of C. These two need not be equal. Hence, the vector triple product does not follow associative law. That is more important here. These two are different. Okay. So to evaluate vector triple product, you can use the dot product like this. That is one more important point. Next point, A bar cross B bar cross C bar, A bar cross B bar cross C bar is equal to, so this is A dot C multiplied B minus A dot B multiplied C, whereas A bar cross B bar cross C bar is, in this case, A dot C multiplied B minus B dot C multiplied A. A dot C multiplied B, B dot C multiplied A. These two are not equal. So hence, therefore, A bar cross B bar cross C bar is not equal to A bar cross B bar cross C bar. Vector triple product does not follow associative law. That is more important here. Need not follow. So therefore, vector triple product need not follow. Associative law. SOCA2. law. Okay. This is one important point related to the vector triple product. Next point. I cross J cross K. I cross J cross K is I dot K multiplied J. I dot K multiplied J minus I dot J multiplied K. This is dot product of perpendicular vectors, hence 0. These two are perpendicular, hence 0. So 0 bar. So I cross J cross K. I cross J cross K is always 0 bar. Similarly, J cross K cross I is 0 bar. And K cross I cross J is also 0 bar. In similar way, you can conclude that J cross K cross I is 0 bar. K cross I cross J is 0 bar. Okay, this is vector triple product. Next point. A bar cross B bar cross C bar is 0 bar implies A bar is parallel to B cross C. A bar is parallel to B cross C. Or B bar is parallel to C bar. B bar is parallel to C bar. Once B bar is parallel to C bar, this is 0 bar, hence 0 bar. Once A bar is parallel to B cross C, then also we get 0 bar. A bar is parallel to B cross C means A bar is perpendicular to the, this is the vector which is perpendicular to both B and C. Hence that implies you can say that A bar is perpendicular to the plane, perpendicular to the plane that contains both B bar and C bar. A bar is perpendicular to the plane. This is the vector. This is the vector perpendicular to both B bar and C bar, or perpendicular vector to the plane that contains B bar and C bar. Since A bar is parallel to this one, A bar is also perpendicular to the plane that contains both B bar and C bar, or B bar is parallel to C bar follows. This geometrically, once A bar is in the perpendicular direction of the plane that contains B bar and C bar, then you can say that their vector triple product is 0 bar. Once, suppose this is the plane that contains B and C, this is the vector in the direction, in the normal direction of the plane. In the normal direction, this is B bar, this is C bar. So A bar is in this direction. So in this case A bar cross A bar cross B cross C is always 0. Here in such case A bar cross B cross C is 0, 0 bar. The cross product of these two vectors is 0 bar. Next problem. find box A bar plus B bar, B bar plus C bar, C bar plus A. Find the box value of A bar plus B bar, B bar plus C bar, C bar plus A bar. In this case, box A bar plus B bar, B bar plus C bar, C bar plus A bar is A bar plus B bar dot B bar plus C bar cross C bar plus A bar. Of course, this is one vector, this is one vector, this is one vector. Cross product of these two vectors dot this vector gives us the box value. Now this is A bar plus B bar dot, cross product is also distributive, hence B cross C here, B cross C plus B cross A. Maintain that order while doing the distributive law with respect to cross product. Maintain the order of the vectors B cross C, B cross A, similarly C cross C plus C cross A, that is equal to A bar plus B bar dot B cross C plus B cross A. C cross C is 0 bar, same vectors cross product 0, the cross product of same vectors is 0, and C bar cross A bar. Again, dot product follows distributive law, hence distribute this vector to all the vectors. Similarly, distribute B bar. So, A bar dot B cross C plus A bar dot B cross A, this is of course 0, plus A bar dot C cross A. Similarly, distribution with respect to B bar. B bar dot B cross C, B bar dot B cross A, plus B bar dot C cross A. Okay. This is vector triple product. This vector triple product may be expressed in terms of box value. Box A bar, B bar, C bar. This is box A, B, A. Box A, C, A. This is denoted by box B, B, C. Box B, B, A. And box B, C, A. Okay. Of course, in box out of three vectors, if two are equal, then certainly the box value is 0. This 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 box value is 0. If any two vectors are equal in the box value, then if any two vectors are equal in the box value, then the box value is 0. Hence, this is box A bar, B bar, C bar plus the remaining terms becomes 0. We get only these two. The cycle of order follows in this box value. B, C, A, cyclic order follows. Hence, these two are equal. Hence, you can write this one as box A, B, C itself. These two are equal. Once the cyclic order follows, these two are equal. Hence, this is 2 into box A, B, C. So, box A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus A bar is twice to that of box A, B, C. This is one important relation. Of course, since box A, B, A is 0, box B, B, A is 0, like that, except if any two vectors in the box is 0, or equal, then the box value is 0. Here from this problem we can conclude that once A bar, B bar, C bar are non-coplanar, that means box is not equal to 0, then these vectors are also non-coplanar because their box value is not equal to 0. In case of box A bar, B bar, C bar is not equal to 0, that is concluded. So you can take geometrically here, you can say that the first one, if A bar, B bar, C bar are non-coplanar vectors, non-coplanar, then we can conclude that then vectors A bar plus B bar, B bar plus C bar plus A bar also non-coplanar, non-coplanar. If A bar, B bar, C bar are coplanar, then these vectors are coplanar. Because box A bar, B bar, C bar in such case becomes 0, hence it becomes 0. That is the second point. Only second one. We can conclude that if A bar, B bar, C bar are coplanar, then immediately A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus A bar are coplanar. The vectors are coplanar. Okay. Third point. From above problem, these points can be observed. If A bar, B bar, C bar be coterminal edges, coterminal edges of a tetrahedron, then volume V is box A bar, B bar, C bar with modulus. Hence, volume of the tetrahedron, one sixth. This is 1/6. If A bar, B bar, C bar be coterminal edges of a tetrahedron, then its volume, volume is 1/6 of modulus of box ABC. Then volume of tetrahedron whose coterminal edges, edges are A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus A bar is equal to, is equal to 2 twice to the top. Okay. This one is 2 into 6V. Because box A bar, B bar, so this box value gives us 1/6 of equal to, I will take like this, 1/6 of modulus of box A bar plus B bar plus C bar, C bar plus A bar. Okay. But this is, this box value is twice to the top, twice to the top box ABC. Box ABC. That is 1/3 of modulus of box A bar, B bar, C bar. But box modulus of box A bar, B bar, C bar is 6A. 6V, that is 1/3 of modulus of 6V with modulus, 2 into mod V. So this is twice to the top volume of the tetrahedron having coterminal edges A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus A bar is twice to the top the volume of the tetrahedron having coterminal edges A bar, B bar, C bar. Like that you can conclude different points based on that problem. Similarly in next one. Find box A bar cross B bar, B bar cross C bar cross A bar. This is different from previous problem. In previous problem, we are finding box A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus A bar. But whereas here, we have to find box value of A cross B, B cross C cross A. That is different from the previous one. Okay. Right. Now, coming to solution. Box A bar cross B bar cross C bar cross A. Equal to A bar cross B bar dot the cross product of these two vectors. Okay. Actually, this is the cross product of four vectors. That may be written as A bar cross B bar dot. Take this one as a vector, total vector. Some P bar. P bar cross, suppose let it be P bar cross, C bar cross, A bar. Which comes under, once you assumed this vector as P bar, it comes under vector triple product. By vector triple product, you can write P dot A. That is B bar cross C bar dot A multiplied C. Multiplied C bar minus B bar cross C bar dot C bar multiplied A bar. That is the evaluation of the cross product of four vectors. Assuming this one, this cross product as one vector, P cross C cross A. So P dot A multiplied C, P dot C multiplied A. So reducing the cross product of four vectors to cross product of three vectors, vector product of three vectors, and evaluation of vector triple product in terms of the dot product. That gives us A bar cross B bar dot. This is box B C A scalar multiplied the vector C bar minus box B C C multiplied the vector. Box BCC is clearly 0. This one, this scalar is 0. Hence, that vector is 0. Dot B bar, C bar, A bar. Box C bar minus 0 bar. Since it is a scalar, you can take that scalar common. Apply this dot product in these two vectors, in between these two vectors. Dot C bar. Okay, because this is a scalar, you can take common that scalar and apply this dot product between these two vectors. Again, this is box ABC. So box BCA multiplied box ABC. This is also in cyclic order BCA. So hence, you can take it as ABC, box ABC into box ABC. Which is box ABC whole square. Because this is a scalar. Hence, we get the square of that scalar, box ABC itself. Hence, therefore, box A bar cross B bar cross C bar cross A bar is always box A bar B bar C bar whole square. Box A bar B bar C bar whole square. This is also one important relation. Once a box ABC is 0, this one is 0. That means once A bar, B bar, C bar are coplanar, then these vectors are coplanar. Once these are ABC or non-coplanar, these vectors are non-coplanar. Like that you can conclude that once ABC or coterminal edges of a parallelepiped, rectangular parallelepiped, it gives us volume of that parallelepiped. So the volume of the parallelepiped having coterminous edges A bar cross B bar cross C bar cross A bar is box ABC whole square, means square of the volume of the parallelepiped having A bar, B bar, C bar as coterminal edges. So like that you can conclude in such a way. So from this point, volume of parallelepiped having A cross B, B cross C, C cross A as its coterminal edges, coterminal edges equal to volume of parallelepiped whose coterminal edges are A bar, B bar, C bar whole square. The square of volume of parallelepiped whose coterminal edges are A bar, B bar, C bar. Like that you can conclude in geometrical way of this relation. Geometrical interpretation that you can give to this problem. From these relations, you can observe these problems. You can ask like this. Find box I plus J, J plus K, K plus I. Box I plus J, J plus K, K plus I. Box I plus J, J plus K, K plus I is twice to that of box ijk. You can straight away take A equal to I, B equal to J, C equal to K. In such case, box A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus A bar is twice the box A bar, B bar, C bar. Now, this is vector triple product of ijk, that is I dot J cross K. That is I dot J cross J is I, I dot I is 1. So the required value is 2. Box I plus J, J plus K, K plus I is 2. You can use the above problems as results. Similarly, find the volume of tetrahedron whose coterminal edges or I cross J, J cross K, K cross I. Find the volume of tetrahedron whose coterminal edges are I cross J, J cross K, K cross I. So these are volume of tetrahedron having I cross J, J cross K, K cross I as coterminal ఏడ్జెస్ ఈస్ 1/6 ఆఫ్ మాడ్యులస్ ఆఫ్ ఐ క్రాస్ జే బాక్స్ జే క్రాస్ కే క్రాస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ యాక్చువల్ ద వాల్యూమ్ ఆఫ్ ది టెట్రాహెడ్రన్ హ్యావింగ్ కో టెర్మినల్ ఎడ్జెస్ ఐ క్రాస్ జే క్రాస్ కే క్రాస్ ఐ ఓకే బట్ దిస్ వన్ ఈస్ దిస్ బాక్స్ వాల్యూ ఈస్ బాక్స్ ఐ జే కే హోల్ స్క్వేర్ ఆల్రెడీ ఏ క్రాస్ బి క్రాస్ సి క్రాస్ ఏ బాక్స్ వాల్యూ ఈజ్ బాక్స్ ఏబిసి హోల్ స్క్వేర్ So box IJK is clearly, one. So this is modulus of 1 square. This is 1 by 6. This is cubic units. 1 by 6 cubic units is the required volume of the tetrahedron whose co-terminal edges are I cross J, J cross K, K cross I. Like that you can apply these two problems as simple results. Next, scalar product of 4 vectors. Scalar product of 4 vectors. Once you consider the product of 4 vectors, if the resultant is a scalar, it is scalar product of 4 vectors. That is, if A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar are given vectors, then their scalar product is the cross product of 2 vectors dot the cross product of other 2 vectors A bar cross B bar dot C bar cross D bar, which is same to that of this cross and dot can be interchanged. Hence A bar cross B bar cross C bar dot D bar. Okay. Assuming this one as one vector, this dot and cross can be interchanged. Or assuming this one as one vector, you can interchange the dot product between these two. In such case, A bar dot, you get cross product of these three vectors. Like that, you can able to find the scalar product of 4 vectors. But scalar product of 4 vector, how to evaluate this scalar product? A bar cross B bar dot C cross D. I will evaluate this one like this. A bar cross B bar cross C bar dot D bar. Because once assuming this A bar cross B bar one vector, let us suppose P bar dot C bar cross D bar. I am exchanging the dot and cross in such case. It reduces to vector triple product. Hence this is A bar dot C bar multiplied B bar minus B bar dot C bar multiplied A bar. Okay. Dot D bar. Now this dot product may take dot product with the vectors. These two are scalars. So A dot C into B dot D minus B dot C into A dot D. This is the value of scalar product of 4 vectors. Of course, to remember this, you can take it as A bar dot C bar as a determinant form, 2 by 2 determinant form, A dot C, A dot D, B dot C, B dot D. Okay. So, A dot C multiplied B dot D minus A dot D multiplied B dot C. So, therefore, A bar cross B bar dot C bar cross D bar is same to that of the determinant of A dot C, A dot D, first row, B dot C, B dot D, second row. Very simple to remember this one. Scalar product of four vectors. Scalar product of four vectors may be evaluated like this. A dot C, A dot D, B dot C, B dot D. Like that. Find I cross J dot J cross K plus J cross K, of course, J cross, do one thing, you just find I cross J dot J cross K. Okay. This is I cross J dot J cross K. Straight away I cross J, we know that is K dot J cross K, we know that I. This is clearly 0. Or you can evaluate with the help of the scalar product of four vectors, assuming these vectors are different vectors. So by scalar product of four vectors, you can take i dot j into I dot k. This is I dot k, j dot j, j dot k. Okay, you can evaluate that vector, scalar product of four vectors with the help of the determinant. I dot j is 0 because these two are perpendicular. Perpendicular vector dot product is 0. Similarly, these two, I dot k is 0. J dot j is 1. J dot k is 0. Evaluation of the determinant, we get 0. You can do like this or you can go like this to evaluate such problems. Next problem. నెక్స్ట్ 1.